I think a big fear I had before I directed my first movie is that you're gonna show up to prep and someone's gonna hand you a camera and say, okay, go. And you're gonna be like, what? But I don't know how to work this camera. How can I be a director? And that's obviously not it at all.
Pat, you guys are laughing really hard and you guys are playing guitar.
Hi, I'm Sofia Alvarez, and today we're gonna be talking about what it was like to direct my first feature along for the ride. This is First Film. I had wanted to be a playwright since the time I was a little kid. Theater was always my first love. And I sort of started out in New York writing and directing, and then realized sort of quickly that it would be good to pick a lane and focus my attention on writing for a little while, and that's what I did. My agent sent me to all the boys and said, read this book, tell us what you think about it. They're looking for a writer. And I read it and I immediately fell in love with it. And I said, I have to pitch for this. I don't remember what I said in my pitch, but it must have been good because I got the job.
What?
Yeah, what if, you know, we let people think that we were actually together?
Writing it was really very similar to writing a play, only in that I was kind of left to my own devices for the first little while. And so I went to my writer's room in Brooklyn, and after a few drafts, they had said, we're gonna make this. And it was my first produced screenplay, so I was thrilled.
Being with Peter was so easy that sometimes I let myself pretend it wasn't fake.
There are things you can do in a novel because you have so much real estate to get inside the minds of characters and go into so much backstory and give detail that for a novel is really like beautiful and expanding, but for a film can get in the way of the plot that you want to drive the movie forward. With To All the Boys, I told myself, I'm going to read the book and I'm going to see what I think are the most important parts of the story. And those parts of the story that stay with me are what I'm going to use as the basis for my adaptation.
You're practically begging to get back together with Jen on the bleachers.
Oh, what, so you're spying on me now?
And I also think when you're adapting a book, especially a beloved book, the audiences will go with you if you change certain plot details. The audience will not go with you if you change the tone, or if you change the characters, or if there are these things that they love about the book for a reason, and then suddenly they think, this is not the book that I fell in love with. This has a different character, or this has a different energy.
You're gonna break my heart, Covey?
After they had a cut of the movie, they sent it to me to give notes on it, and that was the first time I'd ever gone into the edit room for anything, and it was really where I saw how a movie is constructed in post. And it was the first time I learned that a movie is three things. There's the movie you write, the movie you film, and the movie you edit. And the movie you edit is the one everyone ends up seeing. The final script happens in the edit. And seeing that happen in the edit room and getting to play a small part in it for the first To All the Boys movie is what really sort of lit the fire under me to start directing.
This is our story, and we're still at the beginning.
After the second All the Boys came out, whenever someone brought up a project that they might like me to write, I said, I'll only write it if I can direct it. From the time I read Along for the Ride, I could just see the movie and see how I could do it. You know, at the end of the day, you're only as good as your team, and they made me look very good.
What was that?
Dance break.
Happens every night at 6.
You can join in if you want.
Pre-production starts, and all the heads of department have a very tangible task. And people ask me a lot of questions. The biggest surprise about becoming a director, being in prep, was that your main job in prep is to know, which is work I felt like I had already done when I wrote the screenplay. When I first started talking about the look of Along for the Ride with our DP, Luca Del Pupo, we just had a really sort of organic way of working together where we shotlist this movie for 3 weeks. And we really went over every scene meticulously. And even though we'd come up with this very specific shot list, because we were aligned on sort of the feeling of certain scenes, if we got there and we didn't feel like we were getting that, we could be a little bit more on the fly. And I trusted him. And so I think that idea that everyone was making the same movie made my job so much easier. I could just trust them because I knew we were all on the same page. I think you really need to trust your team, which I think and hope I did, but you also really need to trust yourself.
After your stutter start, just prep to go again, and then you can stop.
At the end of the day, you're the one who has to sort of put it all together, and so you better know why you're doing certain things. And I remember talking to Robbie Beck, our head of props, about what books Auden was reading in any of these scenes. And I was like, oh, I know what book she's reading. Like, I will give you a list of what book I think she's reading in every scene she's reading. I have those answers to all those questions because that's what you do as a playwright, is you're world building. And so you know all of this stuff about all of your characters and what you want all of the locations to look like. Everyone has a lane, and when you're the writer, you have a lane as well. But when you're the director, you're just sort of in charge of the highway, making sure none of the cars crash. No one knows the movie better than you do. You know, you're the one who at the end of the day needs to defend it and take care of it and make sure it's what you want it to be.
Tip.
Yeah, it's where all the cool young people hang out. Super fun. Can't miss it.
Okay, that was great. Let's reset again, and this time can we you do the one where it's like, oh, my poor stepdaughter is having a terrible time already.
Yes.
The casting process was interesting because there was another actress who was supposed to play Auden up until days before we were supposed to start shooting.
You know what the penalty for lateness is at a hot dog party?
Tell me. I had remembered from our auditions this actress, Emma Passero, who had never been in a big movie but gave a really incredible audition. And when we lost our former actress, I was just in my head, I was like, it has to be Emma Passero. I knew that I really wanted to rehearse with Auden and Eli before we started filming, to have a couple of days of real rehearsals. And so it was very important to me to get our Auden to North Carolina before we started filming. So the following day, she did a call back with me and the producers and our casting directors. That night, she had a chemistry read with Belle. We were gonna do the drive-in scene for the audition. And so I was like, okay, well, Belle, what was your favorite movie when you were this age? And he was like, oh, well, my favorite movie was this movie called Spirit Horse. And we were all like, what? And then I was like, okay, Belle, tell Emma about Spirit Horse. And he just started telling her about his favorite movie from when he was a teenager.
Spirit Horse, I've never even heard of it.
It's a classic. You have to watch it.
It's a classic. Oh, well, that's what I'll watch tonight, Spirit Horse.
Everyone was in unanimous agreement. This is gonna work. Like, this is Auden and Eli. These are our two. She got cast on Sunday morning. She flew to North Carolina and, you know, had to quit her day job. It was just one of those true Hollywood stories, like, that you never think happens and happens.
The new kid is supposed to bring the beans.
It was all of our first movie. You know, it was my first movie that I was directing. It's Belle's first movie, Emma's first movie. And so we kind of immediately had this sort of camaraderie that we were all in it together, all three of us. And by the time we started, the three of us were just like, we got this. And we really trust one another. And we're able to have a lot of fun together.
You want them to get back together.
Yeah. Belle has more television and film experience than Emma does because he's on Saved by the Bell. But Emma has more theater experience because she went to Wesleyan and graduated from the theater department and has both acted in and directed plays. And so they were both coming at it from sort of a different angle, but they were both so game.
Enjoy tonight. You earned it.
Kevin Tent, who's a really phenomenal editor, was our sort of editorial advisor, and he gave me two pieces of advice that he had gotten from Alexander Payne, because Alexander Payne is his longtime collaborator. And he said, sit in your chair. You need to reserve your energy. So when there's nothing for you to do, sit in your chair. And then he also said, on your last take, say to them, once more but faster, because in the edit, you're always gonna wanna speed things up, and if you have really slow takes, you're not gonna be able to. And then something I got from when Kate Bosworth came to set, on her first day, Kate said, I always like to do at the end a fun one, like one take that's for the actors as the last take. Is that okay with you? And I said, oh, that sounds great. And so much incredible stuff came from that fun one that we started doing it with all of the actors, not just with Kate, because it just always got them out of their heads.
Cool. Thanks.
Have fun.
Cut.
Thanks. Promise?
Sure.
Cross your heart.
Okay.
This is actually another piece of Kevin Tent advice. He said to me before we started, you need to hear it the way you hear it in your head, but you only need to hear it that way once. So once you've got that, like, free yourself up a little bit. unintentionally, I always ended up doing 5 takes. I felt like by the time I felt like we had it, it was always 5. And the 5th one was usually the fun one. And I would say the 3rd one was usually the fast one.
And I want you to give him a very awkward hug where it's sort of like this. I'm gonna show you.
You lose nothing and gain everything by giving yourself variety in the edit. I think every project has to be personal in some way, because if it's not, why do it? For all of these movies, or really for any project I do, the most important thing to me is authenticity of the experience. The feelings that I put into them had to be real for them to feel real to audiences. You would be lying if you were to say that you were writing these teenage rom-coms and were never equating it back to your own teenage dating. Everyone at that age has big feelings.
How'd you know that?
Will you let me make it up to you?
People love romantic movies because people love watching other people falling in love. They're comforting in some ways, and it's fun to go along for the ride.
Thanks for watching Netflix Film. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.